Star Citizen Alpha 3.14 will shortly be in our faces, and we've had a preview and a little bit of a teaser of the Orison Landing Zone and Crusader in all its glory, as well as some of the 3.14 features. Crusader is a real gas giant now, with beautiful clouds and amazing vistas. Sunsets are amazing, and the Orison Landing Zone is a little perfect world contained on platforms that sprawl out into the distance. Phrases used to describe the area were things like an eternal sunset. The area represents the next major milestone in Star Citizen's planetary tech, content, environment, graphics, VFX, and more. We saw the plush version of the space whale that will be a competitor to Pico. I think a lot of people like that little space whaley boy. The garden areas have these cherry blossoms, lily pads, water features that sort of all contrast amazingly. They show off some high frame rate shots of the Orison Landing Zone, its props, little details, features that might help it come to life and make it feel special. The statue and fountain of sort of the space whale are a big visual draw, and it all goes together with kind of a lived-in but utopian vibe that the area has. It's got like these beautiful plazas, these amazing gardens. That's the focus here. It's very clean, but very sort of utopian. Yeah, utopian is the right word. Focused adverts, fonts, brands, Shapeology will help build up the landing zone's theme. The area has NPCs wearing new clothes themed for Crusader, some of which we will be able to purchase. It's styled by like 1950s Americana. That's the theme there. That's the influence when dressing the NPCs. The landing zone looks amazing at night, with a lot of time going into light passes and light placement to really have that zone come to life and really sort of focus on particular features and trees and that sort of stuff. During the day, it's very clean and bright, and at night it's got a much more varied color palette and has the colors making it feel more cozy and secure. The lighting and view distances around these platforms is quite resource intensive though, and they had to be really careful with their lighting budget. It was a big challenge apparently. There are little butterflies and at night fireflies around the garden area. Orison's giant platforms are held up by some giant precision thrusters that occasionally fire to make sure it's sort of like keeping appropriately held up in the sky. They have tried to create realistic clouds, but for a non-Earth-like planet, so obviously that's some form of challenge. There were apparently issues with visual artifacting, which we will still see. They're trying to fix them at the moment, but basically at long ranges in high contrast areas, there's some flickering and artifacting. They have plans for fixing this with some signed distance field occlusion. All this new cloud tech is going to be used for the other clouds around planets and in the game as well. And the tech builds off the gas clouds that we already have in game around points of interest and the space stations, but represents a huge step forward. It's now being used at a planetary scale. It's now being used at a different sort of detailed level. It's not finished though. These clouds have bugs and problems and resource issues and lots of stuff, and they want to make them look better, so they're going to continue to tweak and improve them well past 3.14's release. We saw some of the other areas around Orison as well. There's a sky bar. It's got a little fire pit feature. It's very open. It has seating sort of like in quite an open fashion as well. It's kind of like a giant balcony. There is a big shipyard, an industrial platform as part of the zone too, and they want to continue to expand out Orison, adding more visitable areas beyond its initial 3.14 launch that will be coming later this year. So we're going to be getting a hospital, we're going to be getting Crusader Ship Shop showroom, whale watching tours, and more. But also expect improved lighting and VFX and general polish, lots and lots of stuff going on there, and obviously they want to get those clouds looking even better and performing better. Beyond that, new landing zone and Crusader, ships have had a lot of changes too. The new power management system coming for 3.14 has the new capacitor gameplay. Your interaction with the power systems has changed somewhat, at least in how effective it is. You'll have the ability to use stored capacitor energy to give a system a temporary boost, but also things like laser weapons have capacitors that they need to charge before you can fire them again, and they deplete over use. So you're not going to be able to constantly fire pew 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 pew. Missiles have had a big rework. Ships have a missile operator mode now that gives them more control over missiles, but you have to switch to it, so in single-seater fighters you can't use that sort of and your conventional weapons simultaneously, but obviously in multi-cruise ships, you can have someone literally operating and controlling the missiles. And missiles themselves now use the IFCS 2.0 system for movement and tracking, with various improved behaviours as well. These all combined are going to see vast changes to combat in the patch. Scanning radar and pings had an overhaul as well, a more detailed unified system for information being displayed, and more info available when you scan. It's also a big building block for future stealth bounty hunting, deeper gameplay for scanning radar and pinging in the future, scanning down points of interest, probe gameplay, all that sort of stuff, all needs this. HUDs have seen optimization using sort of the screen real estate more efficiently. The Taurus, that new constellation that we've been waiting for ages, I say new, old constellation, which is finally flyable in game, is shown off here in all its glory. It's got a big cargo hold, that is its main feature. We have two dynamic events coming in the 3.14 cycle, the remastered version of Xenothreat, which should be significantly better, and with lessons learnt from the original Xenothreat we had earlier in the year, and the Nine Tails Lockdown, the latter of which is entirely new, smaller, more localised, and has PvP as a major part of it. Players can back Crusader Security, all the Nine Tails, and then sort of fight each other, trying to defend ships if they're with Crusader, that are trying to scan down where the quantum blockades are, or attacking those same ships if you are the Nine Tails trying to destroy them before they can scan them down. This event will also be run multiple times, and not just through the 3.14 patch. The new surrendering system's in as well, allowing you, if you are a criminal, to potentially get arrested and not lose your life or ship, though you will go to prison. There are a load of changes and tweaks going into 3.14 beyond that as well, so bear that in mind. Lots more is coming, and you'll be like, ooh, wow, ah. Hopefully it's going to be a really good state, that patch. We'll have to wait and see, though. Inside Star Citizen is taking a 3-week break, so the next Inside Star Citizen should be on the 22nd of July. The other weekly shows and content are continuing, though, and I am very much looking forward to getting my hands on 3.14 and being able to make some video content on it once the first wave of PTU is out shortly. And when do I think that's going to be out? Well, I think it will be out within the week, the first wave PTU. But if you're looking for when do I think the live build's going to be, middle of July. That's where I'm thinking at the moment, middle of July for the live build. But what do you think? Are you excited for Crusader, that new Cloud Tekken, the Orison landing zone? I'm going to be making that place my home if possible. What about changes to ship combat? Do they worry you, or do you welcome the change? Who are you going to side with during the Nine Tails lockdown? The Nine Tails or Crusader? Are you looking forward to getting involved with those dynamic events? And do you think frame rates are going to be sub-poor around Orison in the PTU and live builds? What are your thoughts? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Oh, what's this? I just found all your search history online. You filthy boy, buying spaceships and going on ship hub. Zin, show a picture of a sexy ship or something. You should have used NordVPN. It's a VPN, obviously, and it has my seal of approval because I chill for them. Use the links below to get a discount and help protect your data, identity, privacy, and to help with online accessibility. Every month we have a ship giveaway, and June is no different. We are giving away a Mercury Star Runner to one lucky viewer that comments on one of my videos made during June on the YouTubes. Just get involved in the comments section, ask a question, or tell me what you think about the video or the subject we were discussing. Thank you so much to my channel members who have pressed the join button below my videos, and my Patreons as well. Going the extra mile really, really helps the channel. Say thanks for helping the channels in.
Thanks for helping the channels in.
Consider becoming a channel member or Patreon as well, and maybe you'll get some poorly photoshopped naughty spaceship shots. Ooh, saucy. Thanks for watching and all your support.